Welcome to the Union Church-sponsored Blessing of the Animals and training demonstration for animals. Okay. I'd like to just tell you a little bit about the program. My name is Jenny Comeau, and I'm now in charge of the program committee and formerly the mission committee. This is put on by missions and deacons at Union Church. And we've got for you this afternoon a training your animal with kindness demonstration by George Guinlan, who is a dog behavior consultant and also the host of a TV show called It's All About the Dogs, which is seen on public access TV in Biddeford. If you haven't seen it, it's really informative, and he does a great job. George Guinlan, who, as I mentioned, has the All About Dogs Training and Behavior Center, which is located in West Kennebunk, and is also the host of the TV special It's All About the Dogs. George is going to talk about some ways to deepen your relationship with your dog and use positive reinforcement, aka kindness and gentleness, to support their training and behavior. And so, George.
What I want to talk about is called the inverted pyramid. Killing me here, my dog. He wants to go out and do something for you. We'll take him out in a second. I want to touch on our philosophy about starting a dog off. If you get a dog from the shelter or a rescue organization, I want everybody to understand and share this with your friends who are not here. Your first 3 days are very, very critical of helping that dog adjust into the home. First 3 days, sometimes we let the dog come in. We give it a lot of freedom because we feel bad because we don't know their background, or we think that the dog had a rough life, so we're going to try to make up for it. You cannot do that at this stage. You can do this by giving it a safe, comfortable life forever, for the rest of its life. And the way you do that is your first 3 days, you have boundaries established in your home by the family. And what we recommend people do is you make a list and you do some little brainstorming even before a dog comes into your home. It doesn't hurt. It helps tremendously. The list is simple. And you're going to make 3 pieces of paper, and on one paper you're going to write, there are some things the dog's allowed to do whenever they want. And you write down and have everybody in the family write down what is it that you want these dogs to be able to do without any restrictions. Second one is, there are some things the dogs can do, but only with my permission. I'm sorry, that's rule number three. The second rule is, there's some things the dog can never allow to do. And you choose. It's not up to me. It's not up to anybody else. It's not to any dog trainer. It's going to be your choice, but you have to live with the results of what you choose. So, for instance, say somebody in the house wants the dog in the furniture. Another person does not want the dog in the furniture. There are some things you can do, but only with permission. So, if you can teach a dog to get on the furniture, on the couch, only with invitation, with that particular person who likes it, then you're not going to have a dog jumping up on the couch and stretching out whenever it feels like it, but you must have a nice cushioned bed for it available, so when you want it off the couch and it wants to sleep, you can just say, go to your bed. We believe that you must teach the dog what you want and not punish for what you don't want. Does anybody understand that? You teach what you want. You tell your dog what you want instead of constantly telling the dog, no, that's wrong, no, that's wrong, no, that's wrong, that's wrong. The dog jumps on me all the time, and these are the calls I get. Dogs jump, dogs bite, dogs bark, they put their hands on, they grab the wrist by their mouth. These are all learned behaviors. These have been reinforced somewhere along the line. You can stop it. The next 2 weeks of a dog coming into your home is the next critical stage. This is when the true personality of the dog starts to come out. Right now, it's a good little house guest. And if you have a dog that comes in your house right away and you can see issues right off the bat, the dog's telling you what it's about. This is my foundation. If this is my good behavior, what am I going to be like? What's the dog going to be like in 2 weeks? 2 weeks is your next stage where the dog starts to show its true personality. So here's what you're going to do when the dog arrives in your home, okay? Play along with me, okay? I want everybody to make a pyramid for me with their fingers like this, with the point up, all right? It's a simple, simple thing. All you do now is you flip the point down. And it's called, I call it the pyramid, the upside down pyramid, the triangle, the better behavior. Triangle better behavior is simple. The dog has no freedom. There's a lot of restrictions of movement till the dog learns to adjust into your home and learns what your lifestyle is like so they can adjust to it. They don't have a clue what your life is like, but they're doing the best on what they have lived with before they came to you. Do you all understand what I'm saying? Everybody understand? So When do we expand? You expand by the freedom gets, the dog gets more and more freedom with the more training you give the dog. So you must teach these dogs or help these dogs learn a foundation for them to be able to count on at all times. What do you think the number one thing I want all of you to teach your puppy, whether they know it now or not, the number one thing you think a dog must learn? Not to jump up?
Down.
Bed. That's it?
Come.
The recall is extremely important, but the number one thing that you need to teach your puppy before you can teach any of these other things is eye contact. Dog doesn't want to look you in the eyes. It's going to be awfully hard to train them. And you don't have a dog that doesn't come to you. If a dog doesn't come to you every time you call him, he's not your dog. That's how I look at it. You've got to really kind of, you know, get that relationship. If you can teach every one of these dogs that when you look at them, we call it smile with your eyes, and you look at their dog and you smile and you tell them how wonderful they are for no particular reason, just because they looked at you. Think about it, especially for folks that have been married a long time. You can be at a party and you can look over at your spouse and you can tell when they're ready to go just by the look in their eye. Your dogs need to have the same thing, I promise you. You get these animals to look at you, you'll be amazed at how fast they'll start responding. Too many times, dogs are punished by staring in their eye, taking their finger, and Victoria and I often joke that with this finger shaking at the dog, the lips always go. And so our eyes get small, we make this face, and we talk to the dog like they're supposed to understand what that means. So your eyes should always be soft. If you, in time, as the dog starts learning to be with you, and you have to do is just look at your dog and give a little squint, and they'll go, "Oops, okay, I crossed the line." If you, anybody who lives with multiple dogs, you have seen this with your dogs. The dogs just have to look at the other dog, and the other one says, "Okay, I'm fine, I got it." Your eyes are the number one. The way you do this is, when you first get the dog, dog looks at you. Oh, and don't. One more thing as I do this. Think about the name. The name has to have a positive connection with smiling in the eyes. The name means, just like you, should I try this on somebody and see if they know? You know what I'm doing?
Sure.
Should I try your husband?
Okay.
What's your dog's name?
Sola.
And what's it mean?
Son.
No, it means look at me.
That's
do you understand?
Good.
Teach your dog that when you address them by their name, just like anybody else in the family, you want them to respond back. Think of it, it's nothing harsh. I'll use Solo as an example. All right. With your permission. What I use is, I use the Dick Van Patten treats. It's actually a dog food.
Want it?
Good girl. Good girl. It doesn't take long to develop a relationship with a puppy. Good. And so, understand, I don't want the dog looking at my hand.
Oops. Somebody will find that later.
I want the dog to make eye contact. So if I put the treat there and move it away. Silva. Any behavior, good girl. Any behavior gets a smile. But when the eye contact comes up, the hand opens up. The best way I can tell you, when you first take your dog home today, try this with their kibble. Take a handful of kibble. I use put values on food, okay? I have high value, low value, and moderate value. So high value would be something like this, or hot dogs, something you have to find out about what your dog likes. Kibble would be at the bottom of the table because you might have liverwurst, you might have cheese, you might have kibble. So if I put my hand right there, and the dog backs away for 1 second. For 1 second, gets a cookie. Now 3 seconds.
Girl.
And then 5 seconds. Good girl. Good. So what I've done was taught the dog, when they touch my hand, can you hear me without the mic? When they touch my hand, they don't get anything, but when they back away from the hand opens up with the treats. Now I start to move the hand away, and when the dog glances up, good girl, I start rewarding the dog. You can do this with the dogs dinner. You don't have to have, and if you do use special treats, make sure that you cut back on the dog's dinner later on, okay? Because you don't want the dog to end up having too many calories they're not going to get rid of. And so what I do, just to show everybody, if I hold it out here, and I reward any possible, any movement. Good girl! Yay! And it won't take long for the dog to start to make the eye contact. This is a simple version, okay?
Come close.
That's a simple, that's the quick version that you can teach your dog as soon as you get it home from a shelter or from a rescue, or when you get your dog home, when you come home from night, you want to make a connection with your dog. Sit down with a handful of kibble and tell the dog about your day. They'll listen. They won't complain, but they'll be a part of it. So far we talked about eye contact being number one. I'm a believer that there's three things that you'll give me some time, voice.
Yeah,
okay. There's three things that I really believe that if you can get your dog to do for you every time, you can teach the dog pretty much anything after that. One of them is the recall. Second one is to stay with you. Stay with you, make eye contact, not necessarily all the time, but to stay close with you. And the third one is to leave you on command, to go to bed, to go across the room, to go lay down, so you can start playing this really, really easy. I'll show you my favorite game with my dog. It'll be the first time him doing this with a bunch of other dogs, but it'll be quite interesting to see how serious he is. Let me show you my toys first. My favorite toy is my old pig bucket. You don't need this, but Victoria used the... what was it you used on your dog?
A
souffle pan. We like something that's elevated only because the dog doesn't have to be looking down at it. I want them to be aware that they're touching something on cue. And I'll try another dog after I show you a quick demo with Bobby. A kind and gentle training is training with rules. Training with boundaries. Letting a dog run around the house uncontrolled without any... boundaries does not raise a confident animal, okay? Dogs that meet people at the door and jump on them should not be meeting people at the door and jumping on them. They should only be meeting people at the door when they learn how to greet a dog properly. So there's a couple of things you can teach your dog to stop a dog from jumping at somebody at the front door. What is it? Anybody got an idea? I won't want the dog to jump. I have to teach an alternative behavior. My dad used to say, when I introduce you to my friends, I want you to shake their hands like a man and don't kick them in the shins. Okay? So give me something a dog can do besides jumping. Make it simple.
Sit.
Okay, what else? Come on, think.
Lay down.
Somebody said lay down. What's another one?
Go to your bed.
Settle.
Oh.
This is my favorite one. What I teach a dog, is a simple word, settle. Settle means, I don't care if you sit, I don't care if you lay down, I don't care if you stand there. All they want you to do is to settle, relax. Oh, why don't you bring them out? I can't handle her and do it. Oh, she likes all my toys.
Okay, just stand still. Please get me drunk.
So, one of my I'll give away one of my signature sits with a dog. Casey, anytime. Casey, it's not a bar. Ready? Good. I want you to think for a second what I'm doing. Casey. Good girl. Good girl. Casey. Ready? Good girl. What am I teaching this dog? And she's sitting. What am I doing? What's the signal to sit? Crossing my arms. Why do I teach a dog? Every dog that comes to see me learns this. Every single dog that comes to see me must learn this. Why do I teach this to a dog? Why is it so important?
Because that's what people do if the dog's jumping up on them.
What kind of people, especially?
Little kids.
Yeah, children. So if a dog runs up to see a child and the child immediately does this, any dog that's come to see me has been conditioned to sit. I do not use this as an everyday sit command. This is used for a special event with a treat every single time. Every single time. I don't wean it because I don't do it 100 times a day. I just do it once in a blue moon to keep my dog, and sometimes I'll get my dog to chase me
I won't do it because my wife always hides her face when I walk through the field going, ah! Yes. So you can try this at home. At my place, I take 3 hula hoops and I tell children to play baseball, run from one hoop to the other, and when they get to the hoop, turn around and do this, and the dog stops and sits. It's a fun game conditioning the dog how to greet. Okay, you're too easy. But you can see it, if you just teach your puppy, as they're approaching you, if you have a dog that jumps, you must do this as they're approaching you, not when they get there. Do you understand what I mean by that? So if you be the dog, but I'll move to you, okay? To make life easier for you. When the dog's this far away, I'm gonna say settle. And so, so what happens is the dog learns what to do as it approaches me, not after it gets there and already jumps. Have you ever been upset about something and somebody's telling you to calm down, just calm down? It doesn't help, does it? None of the settle, 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 settle. You just got to do it. And the reason you only give one command as little as possible, you may have to give a second one, but the only reason you have to give a single command is give the dog a chance to process. Guys, I'm going to give away a secret. I have to make sure everybody understands. Talking to our dog is like talking to a guy. You got to tell us once and shut up and give us a second to process it. All right? Let the dog process. The dog will do it. But if you have to help it, then you take that slight step back. If the dog jumps on me, I can't see into these 3 jumping. You like? How about this little guy?
Jump?
He's so horrible.
He's been watching these other guys.
Huh?
He's been watching, guys, right. Yeah.
What's his name?
Monty.
And what's it mean?
Look at me.
Good dog, Monty. Nice job. Do you understand what I'm doing? And watch this. Lock your leash so he doesn't go any further. Okay. Now watch his ears. I want you to say his name.
Monty.
Praise him. Did you see his
Monty's
ears?
A good dog.
Did you see his ear twitch?
Yeah.
He said, what? So, okay, now hold on a second. Just say his name softer.
Monty.
Okay, you gave a difference. Now watch his ears again. Praise
Monty. Monty.
Twitch, praise.
Good dog, Monty.
Okay, you have to praise as soon as you see the twitch. Oh. And then when you see the head, you praise. And when before you know it, the dog's going to walk back and say, you got something for me? Because I can get a dog to sit. Now watch this. You wait there. Hey, Monty was a good dog. Nice. A recall is nothing more. I never say come to a dog I've never met. Monty, let's go. Walk with me. Come on. Let's go back. Can you settle, Monty? Can you settle? Good job. Now, we wean away from food, okay? Once the dog learns, it might take 100 times. It may not. I wean away by using varial and random rewards once the dog starts to learn it. So, can Bobby come up? Now, I've never done this with my dog in a group like this. He's flown airplanes, he's been on crisis interventions, tornado disaster work, so I'll be surprised if he doesn't misbehave. Come here, buddy. Good. Now, there's so much I wanted to cover, wrap it though. I'm going to pass on this other thing I wanted to touch on because I want to show you my favorite game to teach a dog. Ready? See? Bark! Good. Good. You're missing it. Okay. Hey, Bob, go find Victoria. Bob.
Good.
The leash is used to prevent the dog from leaving. I never use a leash to force the dog to stay with me. Okay? Let me wrap up and I'll tell you what this was. This touchpad is a go-to exercise, and if anybody's seen the show, their dogs actually will run to whatever I throw on the ground, in this case. We have some brochures. If you weren't happy, we're going to stick around to answer questions that we didn't cover, if you have some, because there's always questions that people have. Victoria can answer quite a few of them for you. If she can, if it's a little bit more for her, over her, then she'll send it to me. I hope you have fun today. I appreciate this moment to be with you. I want you to leave here with one thought in mind. Your relationship. Relationship, relationship. Your dogs are with us for such a short time in our life. We've got to enjoy every second we have with them. So let them know what you want instead of constantly punishing them. And don't look them in the eyes and scold them, because
you want that eye to be positive and call that dog and reward it every time for coming to you. And then you can fix what the problem is. Do you all, folks, understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
Do I believe in corrections? Yes, but they have to be fair, and the dog has to know the difference between right and wrong. Otherwise, it's not a correction, it's a punishment. And if you punish a dog for jumping on the counter, they'll just jump on the counter when you're not there. If you punish a dog for pooping in the house, they'll just poop when you're not there. Let them know what you want instead of what you don't want, and watch the relationship start to grow. And if you have any questions, please get in touch with us and let us know. I'd be more than happy to answer them.
Thank you, George. Nice job.
When they come.
This is Fenway.
This is who?
This is Esmeralda.
Esmeralda.
Nice to see
you.
How much is that doggy in the window? The one with the waggly tail. How much is that doggy in the window? I do hope that doggy's for sale. I must take a trip to California and leave my poor sweetheart alone. If he has a dog, he won't be lonesome, and the doggy will have a good home. How much is that doggy in the window? The one with the waggly tail. How much is that doggy in the window? I do hope that doggy's for sale. I read in the papers there are robbers with flashlights that shine in the dark. My love needs a doggy to protect him and scare them away with one bark.